If you want to build the world's fastest off-the-line production pickup truck, first you'll need some interesting ingredients, like this mysterious blue goo, a lot of liquid nitrogen, a plasma pistol, and of course a 5,000-ton stamping press, along with rolls and rolls of silver sheet metal.
We really get to see the whole process from A to Z. Currently, I'm in Normal, Illinois at the Rivian plant where they build the electric truck and the electric SUV. This video is not sponsored. I did pay my own way to get here, but when you have the opportunity to see how the fastest truck in the world is made, you gotta take it.
Even the golf cart is in Rivian blue.
Along with a lot of the robots in the factory, they've, safety first, they've managed to make the factory very aesthetic. Let's start with the 5,000-ton stamping press. Obviously, a roll of sheet metal is not very drivable at the moment, and in order for us to turn a 2D shape into a 3D vehicle, we need a giant stamping machine that can make 3D shapes. These Komatsu machines were actually originally here in a Mitsubishi factory about 30 years ago. Rivian purchased this plant from Mitsubishi about 7 or 8 years ago, and these stamping presses were part of that purchase. As you peek deep into the machine, you can see it's a 4-step stamping process. We're using the equivalent pressure of 1,000 elephants. Each press and stamp adds more detail to the shape of the hood, until it's finished and conveyed out the other side. I imagine using actual elephants to do the stamping wouldn't be quite as efficient.
Every time that machine comes down, you can feel it in your bones.
Once the top and structural portions of the hood are formed, one edge gets slathered with an automotive-grade structural adhesive and inspected by a robot. Then even more robots come and seam roll the edges together. The hem is created with a few separate passes, while the 20 or so little spider leg-like clamps make room for the seam rollers. Robots are all over the place here at the Rivian factory. My favorite is the large robots wielding a whole side of the truck like it's a katana. The exterior sides are also stamped in one piece and formed from the same roll of metals we saw earlier. And I'm a big fan of how every one of the robots is the same shade of Rivian blue as the new trucks. Rivian can roll a new vehicle off the assembly line every 3 minutes, which means things are moving super fast. The robots you see here are wielding resistive spot welders to hold the frame components together. The doors for the trucks are in a separate part of the factory, getting handled with much smaller robots. These are laser welded inside large enclosures, because laser light is extremely dangerous.
There are 3 laser welding sections. This booth right here is for laser welding the hood, this is for laser welding the doors, and this is for laser welding the rear doors. There are carousels on either side that spin around because the laser light inside is super dangerous, and so they have to block out all the lights so we don't liquefy any eyeballs.
Honestly, I think the bare metal unpainted aluminum Rivians have a pretty cool look to them. But what's even cooler though is how they make the battery. Now you might be like, hey Jerry, where does the power inside a Rivian even originate from? It ain't got no gas in it, and going from 0 to 60 in less than 2.5 seconds makes it quicker than a Lamborghini Huracan. And all that juice has to come from somewhere. The trick is wiring together thousands of little battery cells like this. 7,776 of them, to be exact. The top cap is the positive terminal, and the side casings and bottom edges are the negative, all organized into submodules with 432 cells each. There's a super cool adhesive pulling robot that places a sheet of metal, called a current collecting plate, on top of these submodules. This robot is accurate to within a 0.3 millimeter placement every time. Getting to pull off adhesive all day, this robot is living the dream. Once the current collector is set on top, the whole submodule heads inside an enclosed laser welder. Laser welding is ideal because the laser beam's concentrated energy uses way less heat than traditional welding. Plus, laser welding is way more accurate.
That movement that you're seeing, is it trying to locate the first cell? Because then it extrapolates all your welds based off that first cell?
Each red flash is a weld, and you can see the zigzag hash mark appear in real time on each top cap. I've been calling these 432-celled pack submodules. It's time to sandwich 2 of those submodules together, with a cooling plate placed between them. One robot is using plasma to ionize the surface of the cooling plate. This brings the cooling plate to temperature, and the ionization creates covalent bonds with the thermal paste that another robot has spread across the surface. These plasma-activated, thermally slathered plates act kind of like a liquid CPU cooler in a gaming PC, except for this time, cold or hot liquid can be pumped through the plate to keep the batteries at the optimal temperature. They can output 764 kilowatts worth of energy into the four motors, and 1,025 horsepower is no joke, so cooling is pretty important. Once the cooling plate has been slathered and placed between the two submodules, another machine with a few airbags makes sure consistent and adequate pressure is applied so that the conductive cooling can commence when the coolant is flowing in and out of the cooling plate through these openings. At this point in time, the battery modules are very much alive and very much dangerous. Dangerous, that is, until a special proprietary syntactic blue foam is spilled out onto the surface. The blue foam is a lightweight resin filled with hollow microspheres that act as a structural firewall when it dries. Just like you have a firewall in a gasoline-powered vehicle between the driver and the engine, each little battery now is cozily encompassed in its own firewall. It's good to be as safe as possible, even though EVs are 60 times less likely to catch on fire than a vehicle powered by gas, since, you know, those run on literal explosions. Rivian calls this process potting, since each individual cell is fully encompassed or encapsulated in the blue compound. Kinda like Han Solo in that carbonite, they're all still alive in there, it's just protected for transport. The Empire did nothing wrong.
Oh, it's like plastic.
We'll get to how the motors are built in just a second, but first, each of the newly completed modules with their installed bus bars need to be placed inside of a battery pack. Each of the modules weigh about 150 pounds, so again, robots are used to situate them. The battery pack is modular, just like little Legos. 7 modules go into a large pack, and 9 battery modules fit into the max pack, which provides 420 miles of range. An interesting thing though, since these packs are watertight and the trucks can ford water up to 43 inches deep, about 3.5 feet, Rivian pumps the packs full of an argon gas, which is an inert, noble gas, making sure there is no leaks. If air can't leak out from the inside, then water can't get in from the outside. Now, when it comes to motors, Rivian is also making these in the same factory as well. And I'm not gonna pretend to understand how electricity somehow magically gets the motors to spin. I do know, though, that the motors have 2 parts. A stator, which is the exterior non-rotating part, filled with those copper windings, and then we have the second part, which is the rotor, the internal spinny part that has the magnets inside and some splines. That output shaft is what makes your tire spin. To insert the splines into the rotor, Rivian uses liquid nitrogen. We are all familiar with how things get smaller when it's cold outside, and Rivian uses this shrinkage to its advantage by bringing that rotator shaft down to negative 321 degrees Fahrenheit, and then press fitting it into a hot rotator body. After that, we wait for them both to return to ambient temperature, where the shaft expands and the bond becomes permanent. This does mean, however, that you'll have to be careful driving your new Rivian truck through lakes of liquid nitrogen, or the rotor shafts might again become separated. This totally rules out expeditions to Pluto or Neptune. Once the rotor body has been joined with the stator and placed inside the gear set, it's time to marry the motors, battery pack, and frame with either the body of the R1T truck or the body of the R1S SUV. Efficiently, the floor and ceiling of the entire factory are covered with tracks that bring all the large components together. It's a busy place with a lot of things going on, especially since this is the same factory that builds all of the large Rivian delivery vans. These vans are also probably the quickest delivery vans on the planet, but we'll have to save that test for another video. As a Rivian owner myself, I do have a $500 discount referral code to hand out. I'll leave a link for that down in the description. Up to this point, we've seen lots of robots, mostly doing the dangerous jobs, jobs that require heavy lifting, or extremely repeatable, high-precision jobs. Like this blue guy who's installing the massive glass slabs on the roof of the SUVs. There are also about 5,000 humans working at the factory here in Illinois. Most of them can be found doing the intricate tasks of final assembly as the vehicles get closer to the finish line.
I also like how they're using wood paneling for the moving walkway. So the trucks are all assembled on this side and it's just slowly moving towards the final line.
During that final assembly, one of my favorite parts of the truck, the real wood on the dashboard, gets swung into place. And among other things, the seats get dropped into the body. And of course, all four wheels need to get lugged up tight. Rivian lets you know which Rivians are the fastest with the blue brake calipers.
And there you have it, the world's fastest truck rolling off the assembly line, faster even in the quarter mile than a McLaren F1. Very impressive truck, very impressive factory. Thanks Rivian for letting us come out, and thanks a ton for watching. I'll see you around.